Parker, and today I'm here at the Tottenham Hotspur training ground, and I catch up with teammates Hugo Lloris and Clement Longley. We talk about well-being and the importance of switching off from the game, even if it's just a little bit. Hugo, Clement, we're talking well-being, and you know, it's a really important topic, something that we're not afraid to talk about anymore. And I'd love for you to both just share why well-being is really important to you, and when it comes to just like your emotional, mental, physical, like who do you talk to?
I think that there was an evolution during my career. So at the beginning, I used to share a lot with my father. And then obviously I get married, I got children, I got more mature. So probably I will go to my wife now if I want to share some feelings. But also I used to be very demanding towards myself, and I used to spend a lot of time to reflect on my own, you know. You know, we spend a lot of time in hotel,
of course.
And sometimes you just think about life, you just think about your job or family or anything, you know.
And how about you, Clement? How, you know, who do you talk to when it comes to your well-being?
I like to be with my family, to share moments with my son.
So your son?
Yes.
Oh, lovely,
yes.
Lovely.
Yes. A young boy. And before that, I was with my brothers, my father. They play football a lot, so it was a lot of moments with my family, yeah. My friends,
yeah.
to feel good and to be healthy in the mind.
I'm kind of thankful that we're in a generation now where we're free to talk about these things, right?
Yeah, but you know? I've got three kids, and obviously every time I have the possibility to spend time with them, I do it. And it's the best way to switch off, you know, from the football world. It's like when I spend the time with them, most of the time I will say I'm only focused on them.
Yeah.
But sometimes, you know,
tough,
you are with someone, but you think about something else, and that's no good.
Yeah.
That's no good.
I mean, that segues perfectly. Like, how, other than, obviously, you both mentioned your family, which you're both really dedicated to, and family time is one of the ways in which you switch off. How else do you like to switch off from football?
Two different things. When I arrive at the training ground, mm-hmm. and when I leave the training ground. No, but with time, I learned how to manage better, you know. Probably when I was younger, I was footballer, connected football 100%, and I don't think it's healthy, and I don't think it's on the long term is not really good. But I prefer to be focused less time on football, but you do it 100%, you know. And then when you are at home, just focus on family, and that's how you get the best feelings, probably.
You both talk about how once upon a time football was like very intense, and obviously this is football, but that's also, if you, I don't know, if you're a teacher or you work in finance or you're a doctor, it's also a very intense situation. If you were just to share with somebody who's like, you know what, I need to spend less time at work and a bit more time like appreciating what's going on, what piece of advice would you give them?
I will put focus on quality time. Doesn't matter what you do, you know. I don't know, when you spend time with friends, you try to have quality time. When you spend time in work, you try to, you know, to have quality time. It's always try to find the right balance. Obviously, when you do too much, probably you start to be more less effective. And what you are looking for when you are doing something is to be effective.
Of
course. No? Also your mind, you know. I probably think it's good to, you know, to separate things.
Absolutely, 100%. Yeah. Obviously, we've got lots of young players coming up through the academy. Obviously, kind of, you would have come through an academy once upon a time. What kind of advice do you give them, you know, when they're coming into this environment, which, let's be real, you know, academy football into like men's football, first team football, is totally different. So what? How do you kind of put your arm around them?
The most important thing is to be ready to fight in every moment, to fight against adversity, to fight against you, because you are always, you need to improve every day, so you need to put your exigence every day more higher. No, the work is the most important way to be a professional in the long term, because you can have a lot of talent, but if you are not working every day, it's much more difficult to be a good player and to be a very big, important player. So to be ready to work and to fight every day.
I always used to say you have to work, you know. No, but it's true, yeah. The work is the priority. And then in your evolution, obviously there is up and downs, but I probably give more credit to young players when they face difficulties, the way they react, the way they bounce back, and because this is a kind of aspect of the personality, you know. So because football is very hard. From outside, probably we think there is only positive things, but it's not true. You get hurt every day. You get hurt, you know, every game, and you face difficulties. But you have to make sure that you are strong, you know. And probably through your experiences, you develop an aspect of yourself that make you stronger.
So you both obviously have moved countries for your career. How have you learned to deal with that, especially like moving your family and, you know, starting a new family in another country? What kind of tools or tips can you share that has helped you along the way?
I think it was something that I was looking for, you know, after a few years spent in the French League. I wanted a new challenge, and when I had the opportunity to come to the Premier League, I was just excited, because it's probably the best league in the world and the most competitive league in the world, but also an experience, you know, in your life, for my wife, for my kids, and that's the beauty of our job, you know. We meet a lot of people from different countries, different culture, different religion, and we are unit, you know. For many days, we spend a lot of days together, and I think we try to know well each other, but it comes very naturally, you know. We become friends, and we just try to spend the time in the best way.
I guess, Clement, even though, as you're, like, you've come from France, come from Spain, you're in the UK, I guess, like, how have you had to prepare, just knowing that, you know what, again, I'm having to move?
The family is ready. My girlfriend is totally ready to move, and she accepts my decision. So it's always a decision I take with my family. But when you know your family is ready, it's more easy for you to move. And it's always beautiful to go in another country and to understand this country. For example, in England, it's totally different than Spain, and I'm learning a lot in this way.
Brilliant stuff. Well, Clement, Hugo, thank you so much for your time.